Hello friends, welcome back. In the previous video, we saw that for a customer problem, we are showing him various solutions, various options, and the cost of the other different options. For example, his case was he wanted a custom AI solution. He wanted an AI solution for invoice scanning and extracting the fields. For that, we have shown that we can use either go for on-prem or we can opt for Microsoft Azure or Google Cloud. Google cloud based solution, and also shown the cost, and based on that customer was able to decide that which one to go. But how, what was the base? That's what we are going to discuss here. To come, we please note that when we are going to a customer, we should have base for every number, everything that we are going to present. So that's what we are going to make here. Now, because this is a simple problem, I have picked it and I have not taken all the questions into account, so that your understanding is simplified. I've taken only majorly 6 questions, but in practical life there can be almost 20 questions or 15 questions like that, right? So let's choose. So what our problem was, customer wanted a solution, this kind of solution where it will scan the invoice or any form and will extract the fields which customer can, and extract the fields into a database which customer can use for different use cases. If you are building this AI solution, what would you need? You basically need what type of documents are there. The option can be, it can be scanned or digitized. Scanned means where the text cannot be selected, and a digitized is one. Digitized PDFs are one which where you can select the text like this, and so it is easy to extract the text from digitized PDFs, and in the invoices with the OCRs, and in the scanned invoices you may have to run the OCR to extract the text, right? So and when you ask the question from the customer, customer says both type of documents are used to come to me, scanned as well as digitized, as well as both. And then you are going to ask, if it is a scanned one, then whether the inputs are handwritten or typed or both, right? Customer says both kind of documents come to me. Then you are going to ask, what would be the language of your document? Customer says it's a English mostly, right? So you will say English. If suppose there multiple languages are coming in, then we will select multiple, right? As you can see that when I selected multiple, our solution became high complex, right? So how it is going, I'll show you the formulas as well. Then language specifics, it is English, Chinese, and all that you can select. For the sake of simplicity, I've just used two options here. See, whatever the drop downs are there, English, single, medium, I have created these list here, scanned, digitized both, and given a weight to them, 2, 1, 4, typed, handwritten both, 1, 4, 5. So this how you can make it, and of course you can make a drop down in Excel, right? So percentage of segregation between the different types of, there are multiple options we can choose. Now if suppose customer says no, more than 90% of documents are scanned document, then your solution will become high complex, because scanning handwritten data is more error prone, and you have to put more if and else statements or more robust solution to get the right content out of those handwritten, right? So it will become customer has said that 20% of the cases. How to access the document? That's another question that we had. How the documents, your OCR solution can have, you whether it is coming to you in a shared drive, or which you can directly upload to Azure, or you can directly feed to your Tesseract, or it is on a tool from where it has to be downloaded. If this is the case, this can create problem for you, so manual download will be required. So this kind of questions you can ask. So based on this data, what I have done is I have given a weight here, right? And this weight you can see is reflecting here, 4, 5, let's say suppose multiple languages are coming, so the weight will become 2. So here, to calculate this complexity, I did a sum of all these weights, right? And whatever the weight, if this sum is greater than 12, then it output your solution will be high complex. Now this 12 number is not hard coded that it has to be 12 in your case. If you use this calculator as it is, then 12 may work for you, but in your case, suppose you had more questions, then your total number may change, and then probably you would like to change this numbers. So right, this is how generally you make the calculators, and you have to make these calculators when you are building a capability or a practice wherein you have a product and you want to sell it, you want to take it to the customer, then this can, then you have to prove that what you are giving to the customer, right? So this is the weight that you have calculated. Based on that, you have got the complexity as well. Another question that may be of interest for you is how much volume is coming for per month. Now this is your one-time cost. Now this is your one-time cost that is coming in, because you have to anyway develop the solution. It does not matter, suppose only one invoice comes in a month or 1 lakh invoices come in a month, it does not matter, right? You have to develop the solution. So this complexity will decide your one time cost, and whether the volume is there or not, this will decide your return on investment, not your customer's return on investment. Suppose customer says only 100 documents come in a month, then you can say it is giving poor ROI. Means if he is spending $10,000 from his pocket for just 100 documents, then rather he will put a human being there, and he will that the cost of that human being may be very less than your AI solution. And suppose he is saying no, I'm getting 15,000, so it will get a good ROI. How this is coming in, this is coming on based on this formula. You can see number of invoices, number of documents that are coming per month divided by 22. What is that 22? 22 is the number of working days in a month. You can see, let's say 21 days were there in January 21. If I go for March 22, then 23 working days are there in March. So generally at 21, 22 or 19, this kind of figure is taken with company to company. So let's say 22 working days are there, 9 hours in a month, 9 hours in a day, and divided by 60 minutes per hour. So what you get is this, and this formula says if this is one factor. Second factor is the human touch time. It is called as AHT as well, average human time or human touch time or average handling time. So the multiple words are there into the industry for this. Now suppose you take this AHT as 10 minutes, then if you multiply 15,000 by 10 minutes, then how much it comes out to be? Let's say 15,000 multiplied by 10. So approximately 150,000 minutes are being spent per month by employees working in your organization. Let's say, so if I divide it by 22 days, divided by 9, divided by 60, so it says that approximately 12 FT or full-time employees or 12 resources are required to take care of these documents, right? So here, this is a simple calculation. Now suppose you ask a question, how many resources have actually deployed to do all this work? They say 9. How much are required? Actually 12. We have just calculated. So it means they are already in short of 3.6 resource, but practically it may not be the case. They may be having 10,000 and 5 minutes, right? Then you will get an average ROI from your solution, and they are already having 4.8, means 5 resources they are already extra. So these two factors, this is just an indicator, right? This is when you are going for a customer. So in this calculator, you can feed in these two numbers, and this will give you an average ROI or poor ROI or good ROI. So this will help you identifying whether you should pick up this case or not. It should not happen that you take some project, do one-time costing. Your one-time costing may be high complex, but your ROI is poor. Then probably you would not like to go for that specific AI solution, AI project. Well, ultimately, you will be questioned, why did you pick it up, right? So you and I hope you have understood the use of this first page calculator. Whether you should take this project or not, whether you will get a good ROI of this project or not, that's what it is going to tell you. Okay, now number of unique formats, we have taken 10. And one more thing, this may be required. If they are already having some solution, then any compatibility check is required. Suppose they are already using Azure and you go for I'll go for a Tesseract one, then or the Azure one or Abbey one, then you need to check whether your solution and their existing solution is compatible or not. That's another check you have to make. So I hope you will be able to make this kind of calculator for you by seeing these formulas. I have seen this, and this is your base data. This and this is the weight that we had, that I have supplied for every possible combination. Okay, so that is part one of this tool, that whether you should pick this one or not, and whether it is going to give a good benefit to the customer or not. Second thing, if you remember in this presentation, after displaying this complexity, what we came to is what is the cost. What is the one time cost, and what was the run cost, means what was the year on year cost. To calculate this, let's go to the costing part. But cost cannot come easily, because you cannot simply go ahead and say, okay, I'll need $10,000 for this. You need to have a base. And how will you arrive to this? First, you need to calculate the effort. Effort means how much time or how much hours you are going to spend to build the solution. Now in our case, where customer is looking for an invoice scanning solution or OCR solution, we have two options. One is a cloud based, which can be Azure, Abbey, or Microsoft, also Google, like that, right? And another solution is on prem. These two are almost same. So we'll see one. So let us focus on this part first, this area. So cloud based effort calculator. I put everything into one because this is an easy thing. This is an easy demonstration. For you may want to make a bigger effort sheet and put into different sheets. So first of this, consume cloud API. What will you do? You have to, for a cloud-based solution, you will simply go ahead and consume the API of the cloud, right? So how much effort it may be required? Let's say 3 days. Generally, it may take 1 or 2 days, but let's say with unit testing and all, it may take 3 days. So this is nothing. This is simply equivalent to this. Write custom rules per format. Now, for every invoice format that is coming to you, you may have to do some formatting, or you may have to do some rules. Let me tell you with an example. If you see this, here the invoice, you have to put all this data into this specific format. Here the address, here this. Suppose it contains a tabular data here, then you may not easily show the table here, right? So in that case, probably you, for that specific tabular format, you have to display it, or you have to show it, or you have to store it into a different format. So these are the custom rules, I can say. How many are there? 6. We had taken say 10, right? So suppose per format you take 6 days, so how much it will become? We had asked number of unique formats were 10, so 10 into 6, 60, right? It became 60. So 60 days you would need for all those different formats. Even after consuming the simple API, you still not need 60 more days. See this, based on your developer time, you can just change it, say 5 days, 4 days. Suppose you make 3 days per format, then it will become 30 days, right? Now, after building your all the backend, you have to build a front end as well. Like this has been meant. Google may not be giving it. You may have to build your own, right? So how much say 10 days you have taken. So how much total development time is required is total 73 days. Easy. Now you will do integration testing, you will do the deployment, and you will do a production testing as well. Let's say 7 days, 3 days, 3 days. So it will become your 13 days for your deployment and testing. So this is your testers and developers. Now you have to put some extra people over there. For example, you need to put an architect, you have to put a project manager, right? They will continually be sitting there, although they may not be 100% occupied, but still they will be there from end to end, right? So let us total up all these days and make them sit here. Okay, so 86 days these people will spend, 73 days developer will spend, and 13 days your tester will spend. Now let us say the cost. On an average, this cost varies companies to company. Now in your company, in my suppose hypothetical company, suppose the developer cost is $2 per hour. A tester cost is almost same $2 per hour. A project manager architect may be expensive, so it's $6 per hour assume. But they will not be occupied 100%. Let's say they are occupied only 25%. When the remaining 70% of the time, they are looking at the other projects. But developer and tester have to be fully occupied during that time. So 100% utilization. So simply multiply the rate card this rate with their utilization with the number of days they are going to spend there, right? So it is going to give you the cost. Tester cost will also come to you. Project manager cost will come like this. So your total project cost for a cloud-based solution comes out to be $3,000. Okay, for an on-prem where you are building the solution, you will not consume the cloud API, but you will write your own code for your own code for what? Tesseract, OpenCV, Tabula, all these kind of solutions. So suppose you take 2 months for this, 60 days. Here 3 days and here 60 days. See, and other numbers are all same. Only thing is, because it is your custom solution, you may have to do a lot more integration testing, little more deployment effort, and little more production testing. So you have increased this number, then again same thing you come out to be your total done. And in the same formula you can see this is absolutely same, no difference. You just put in there and you get $6,930. See, double of the cost, right? Two costs we have calculated. This is one time cost, this is one time cost. But you have to do a support cost as well. Now the support cost, a support engineer, same $2, a project manager and architect may be required. So architect I put in 0, project manager may be required just 10%. Very less project management role is required in the support case. So if you see, for complexity, remember we had calculated this complexity, that complexity. Okay, first give me a minute. So here, first of all, let us calculate the hours. So cost, so 50% this support engineer will spend with this with $2 cost per hour, and you will get this cost, you will total up. So you can say that $316 you are spending regularly on your project for supporting this. Okay, so your base is ready. You can put this formula into your calculator and to your calculations, and you will get approximate cost. But this is a base of the final cost. Your final cost comes here, and customer has said that 10,000 pages are there, or 15,000 pages are there, let's say. So first of all, you need the different cost of Azure and Google. So you need to research here a little bit, for I have already done the research, and these are the URLs. Okay, so if I show you, this is the pricing of the Azure OCR solution, Cognitive Services Pricing Form Recognizer API. So it says that your custom invoice is $50 per hour, and for the pricing of Google is $65 per 1000 pages. Okay, this is the this you have put in here, $50, $65. For on-prem solution, you nothing. Because the solution is built on your on-prem, whenever you are going to hit it, no separate cost. So what you are going to do, your 15,000 documents are there, so you are going to multiply your 15,000 with this 50. Now this $50 is for per 1000 page, so you will just divide this 1000 with this 50. Approximately you are going to get a $750 you would need per month for calculating the for the Azure thing. Now you are, this is what you are going to pay to Microsoft whenever you are going to send your invoices to Microsoft. Same way, $975 you are going to send to Google. But it's a your own company, right? You or your, even if it is not your own company, but it's a you are a consultant, you have to earn some money for your company as well, where you are working, right? So you are going to add a markup. this is everybody knows that it is done based on your company standard. You're going to multiply it with 50% or 200% or even 250%. It all depends upon how goodwill your company has. It suppose mine is suppose an average company, and 1 point, I'll say 50% margin I will take on top of whatever the cost you are going to send to the Google. So instead of charging $750, I will charge $1,125 from the customer. So one time cost is 3870, which came from here for this specific solution. Same 3870 for Google as well, both cloud-based solution, but our run cost is this one. And support cost is 316, and solution one time cost is for our on-prem solution is 6930. Okay, so if there are formulas here up and down little bit, that's okay, because I have made it for demonstration purpose, but I hope this will give you the idea that how this number generally get calculated. Okay, and how you actually are going to talk to the customer, what you are going to present to the customer. When you are presenting this cost to the customer, you are going to hide that markup cost. You will simply show the run cost and you will show the one-time cost. Now this has come to you. Final thing is, which one customer will choose? For that you have to make this Pareto. How you are going to make this Pareto is same in the tool. You will type 01020304050. You will say one-time cost. This will be your markup cost and one-time cost. This is year one. That's what, and this is actually the month one. I should have multiplied it with 12. That's okay. So this one, then again this Google cost markup at one time, and for this on-prem this will become like this. So if you draw and the for the year two, you are not going to charge any one-time cost. You will just charge the runtime cost. Although we can show this as well, but for making this chart, what we have done is we have added to the previous year cost. So overall, at the end of the 5 years, suppose customer will pay 9.4k from F2 in case of Azure case, 11k for Google case, and 8.5k for on-prem case. So you can clearly see that at approximately these after 5 years, your on-prem solution becomes cheaper. So if you draw this into this using this line charts, you can see how it is cutting in. Wherever this cut is happening, where there is crossover is happening, means this red line means Google one is becoming expensive than your green ones with on-prem solution. Right. That's how actually it works. I hope these all calculation and this calculator will land you into an easy position when you are planning or building an AI solution and taking it to the customer. Thanks for watching.